Hello fellow tankers, in this video I will present you some strategic tips for the Eastern Europe map, and then we'll comment gameplay. So this domination map is in the vertical class. If you have already watched some of my videos, I define vertical maps by the fact that each side have a natural cap, A for the red side, C for the green side, and essentially the fight is on the B cap. If for instance the red side capture C, that means that they probably have also captured B, and it means that the green side is in very big trouble. So essentially this kind of vertical maps are very similar to conquest map, where essentially you would have only this central cap. So let me first address the fast cap of the central cap. From the red side, the main route is the best, and you can hide behind houses here. Really refrain from shooting at tanks before you cap. If there is no green tanks on the cap, please cap before shooting at other tanks. Don't die while you are capping. While you are on B, you may already look whether they are tanks on the other side of the river. Let me mention that it's very nice when a red tank very fast goes along this wall here, and so that it will be able to intercept green tanks coming to cap B. This position here is one of my favorite, and the best is to go there obviously with a fast tank, and possibly with a tank with a fast reload. It's maybe in the future I will make a video where I'm actually taking this position. This position is absolutely superb in arcade and in RB. From the green side, the approach let's say, not more complicated, but the problem is that because of the position of the C cap, very often you will have too many people going there and losing time, and actually then taking a bad position instead of massively going to B, going this way and then along the main road, and then hiding behind the house in the center of B. So of course when you arrive here, you have to anticipate that there is maybe someone already here, but if not, the approach is pretty safe. But really be aware that sometimes there would be a fast tank there. So the battle to ultimately get B, let me mention the important zones. So very often what happens is that you will have a lot of green tanks in this street, inside this building here, a lot of red tanks in this area, maybe in this area. All this is not very productive. The most important zone on this map is this area here along the river. So the red tanks can come along and then help in this position, come in this position, or shoot at tanks, green tanks popping from peeking from these streets, this one, and even sometimes campers on the other side of the river. So you have to be very careful of campers on the other side of the river, including in the high ground here. You have actually pretty good camping spots, as you will see in the video. But really this zone in a north survey along the river is very important, from the green side, my advice is that if you are on B, sometimes you can actually cross, but you can also come in this area, either from here or directly from here. You have to be a bit careful. So the reason why this area is also important for green is that then they can shoot at all tanks over there and clean this area of people which are honestly not very useful, but which are still there and so potentially dangerous. So this area is very dangerous, and obviously a nice way to counter the fact that you have enemy tanks in this area is actually also to have a certain presence on the other side of the river. And so let me mention that you have good camping spots in the high grounds, but you can also come in the low grounds and shoot at people from B. Honestly, if you decide to go in the low grounds, don't take this position here, which is not that efficient. I mean, it's not bad, but maybe really try to come a bit more in the center. You have some cover, it's a bit more dangerous, but at least you will see really the people here. Because if you have a green tank really really at this corner from this spot, you will not be able to shoot at it. Same from the red side. I mean, you can indeed shoot from this area, but if you get a bit closer to B, a bit more perpendicular to B, you will be really able to shoot at the most dangerous tanks on B, but also in this area. So just to summarize, this little area in the north of B is really absolutely crucial, and a good way to either prevent the enemy to occupy this area, especially in IBR, is either to have a few snipers in the high grounds or people covering the other side of the river. And of course, trying to kill the enemy tanks in this area. That's very important. When you are in this on the other side of the river, you should not only concentrate in shooting at tanks on the other side of the on this side of the river, but you should also concentrate on cleaning this side of the river. Well, let me mention that in a really low BR, the lower the BR, the less decisive would be to be on the other side of the river, especially sniping. If you are sniping in tier 2 or even tier 3 from this area, that will not be very effective. But obviously in tier 6, tier 7, where the shells are very fast and very powerful, sniping from the high grounds can be indeed very efficient. Let me just comment sniping, camping from the forest here. In arcade, it's honestly very inefficient, but flanking from the south here can be actually quite interesting in RB. It's a delicate maneuver, obviously, but if you really exploit the trees, which will also block your view, unfortunately. I mean, you can try some sneaky flanking, but honestly, in arcade, camping in all this area is completely useless. Let me mention that there is a big temptation to camp on sea. It's pretty useless in arcade and in RB. So let me start the gameplay. So I'm going of course I'm really preferring to play from the other side, where I love this position on the side of B. and I'm going immediately on the side of this house, which is where you should from this side cap the zone. From the other side, you can be on the other side of this house, whose access is not too difficult, or there is a house behind, which also cover as a reasonable cover. So here my goal is to go along the river, and you note that my two squad mates have decided to go on the other side of the river and to cover exactly this riverside. So one is going in the low ground and the other one is snapping from very far away, and here I access the other side of the river. And here you would see that this position is pretty powerful. And you see that I feel very safe because my teammate here, if you look on the minimap, is not staying here, which is pretty useless, but he's actually helping me cleaning the other side of the south side of the map. So here I'm a bit careful about this Mikalides guy, who is a pretty good player, and I know that it can be very dangerous. Kind of wrecks me, and unfortunately I'm killed . But so far so good. The game is going well, and you notice that my teammate killed the guy on the other side of the river. Really, if you are going on the other side of the river, please be active. You should not just shoot at tanks in the area of B, but also clean this area. I see too often green and red tanks shooting at B, but in the same time not attacking each other. So it's very important. Let me accelerate that. It's not very interesting. So after my Leclerc died, I'm coming with my MX-40, with a beautiful Sensub camo. It's the training center for a French tanker camo. And you have also the Forad camo, which I am taking on the Leclerc, which is the camo for the enemy in the French training center. So they are not these are actually real camos which are used in the training center. Here you see the damage I'm killing actually the loader of Mikalides with my 20mm. Sometimes it goes through the turret ring and can inflict huge damage. Again, if you are playing MX-30s or MX-40, you should definitely use without restraint your 20mm gun. And here I'm essentially wrecked by the 81, but the ultimate dies, but I'm in a very bad shape. Let me just comment, the game is almost finished. Unfortunately my teammate, squad mate, just died here, but he did a very good job because there was a lot of pressure around here. Very good job in cleaning this area. So at this point the game is not is almost finished. I'm not taking a backup of the Leclerc, I'm taking my MX32 because I'm pretty sure we will win. And so thank you for watching this video, and I hope that you enjoyed the strategic tips and this gameplay, and I obviously invite you to consult my two tutorials. The links are in the description. So thank you and see you in battle.